So as you can see, exactly counting the number of time steps, even though we have a very simple model of just three rules and a code that doesn't even have a variable input, is already quite tedious. So we're later going to introduce a number of additional simplifications that will give us a little more leeway here so that we do not have to go through this exact counting process but still learn something about the algorithm. So in general, the capabilities of the RAM closely match what you would expect from your own computer, but of course it's a simplification. But nevertheless, it's a rather solid model. So it's difficult to design an algorithm that, when you analyze it, will give you a very different idea about its performance than you would get on the RAM. Nevertheless, I think it's important to think about the differences between a RAM model and a normal computer. And we'll do this as a quiz. So here are four main simplifications that I think the RAM is making. So here are four properties of the RAM. The first one is simple operations take only one time step. The second one is we assume that we have as much memory as we need. The third one is that memory access is considered to be free in terms of time. And the fourth one is that a unit of memory cannot hold an arbitrarily large number. And of course, this is going to be subjective, but I would like you to tell me which of these four properties you think is realistic, in the sense that it comes pretty close to a real computer, and which of these you would consider unrealistic, meaning if you were to run your algorithm on a real machine, then there would be considerable differences. And again, the answers to these are subjective, so if you get stuck or if you disagree with me, just click next and see where our opinions differ.